Hello, this is Dr. Kathy McGuire of Creative Edge Focusing. Today I am going to help you to apply Gendlin's focusing to Ken Blanchard and Margaret McBride's little book called The 1 Minute Apology. Focusing is a way of going back and forth between your body wisdom, your intuitive feel in response to a question, and making words and images that exactly match that intuitive feel. So by going back and forth, you set aside what you already know in your mind, and you ask a question, and then you wait quietly to see what comes in the center of your body in response. And then you go back and forth between that intuitive feel and words or image that could exactly capture it. So Blanchard provides a rubric for making the 1 minute apology, which has a lot in common with a 12-step approach to reconciliation. But if you add Gendlin's focusing to the questions that Blanchard asks you to ask yourself, and sit quietly until you get a body feel, you'll get beyond your everyday already known thinking and really come up with some new surprises and some deeper information that might really lead to deep change in your behavior. What I like about the Blanchard and McBride book called The 1 Minute Apology is simply by naming the need for this, they've opened the door. In the book, an assistant notices that his boss has made a really big mistake and is now trying to cover up for that mistake. And through the process of the book, the assistant finds a way to help his boss fess up, make the 1 minute apology, and fix the problem. And it's just a delightful concept. It makes it acceptable to walk into your boardroom and say, "I need to make a 1 minute apology," and tells you how to do it and get it off your chest and move forward. So what a delight not to have to carry these mistakes and try to cover them over. This applies not just to work situations, but to anywhere, in your family, in your intimate relationships, with your friends. We all make mistakes and we are all tempted to cover them over. So the 1 minute apology can help us get on with our lives. And again, we're going to combine it with Gendlin's focusing, go and close our eyes, go inside, and do a kind of a deeper process at the end of this exercise. But first, I just want to walk you through Blanchard and McBride's 1 minute apology rubric. This would make a great book to give to anybody. We all need this permission to make apologies. So, step number one in Blanchard's method, and we'll do the exercise later with pauses for focusing. So right now I'm just kind of giving you an overview. So the first step of the 1 minute apology is you ask yourself, "I ask myself the following questions and I answer truthfully. What mistake did I make? Did I dismiss another person, their wishes, their feelings, their ideas? Did I take credit when it wasn't due? Why did I do this? Was it an impulsive, thoughtless act? Or was it calculated? Was it a result of my fear or my anger or my frustration? What was my motivation?" And again, in focusing, we'll stop and sit quietly and really ask ourselves, well, what was my motivation? And see what comes, not our already known excuses, but our deep body wisdom. But right now, just going through the rubric. So what was my motivation? How long have I let this go on? Is this the first time or is it a repeated time? Is this a behavior that's becoming a pattern in my life? What is the truth I'm not dealing with? And am I better than this behavior? And again, in the focusing exercise, we'll take time to really sit with our intuitive knowing, a deeper answer for each of these questions. So next, after answering questions about what did I do and why, you begin, he says, your 1 minute apology with surrender. I am truthful and admit to myself that I've done something wrong and I need to make up for it. And this is like any 12-step program. I take full responsibility for my actions and sincerely recognize the need to apologize to anyone I have harmed, regardless of the outcome. I have a sense of urgency about apologizing. I act as soon as possible. I tell anyone harmed specifically what I did wrong. I share how I feel about what I did with those who've been harmed. So that is called surrender, just giving over, being truthful. And then I complete my 1 minute apology with integrity. I recognize that what I did is inconsistent with who I want to be. I reaffirm that I am better than my poor behavior and I forgive myself. I recognize how much I have hurt other people, and I make amends and demonstrate my commitment not to repeat the action by changing my behavior. And we do know that when we make a mistake, we do apologize, and that part of that apology is making whatever amends we can for what people have suffered because of our behavior. So that is Blanchard's rubric. Now we're going to go through it, but pausing to use Gendlin's focusing to let a deeper body response come to these questions. And then using focusing, we'll carefully look for words or an image that freshly capture that intuitive wisdom. Check any words or images that come against the body sense until our body says, yes, that's right. That captures it. And then we'll go on to the next question or the next part of Blanchard's rubric. So this will take about 10 or 15 minutes. And I invite you to sit down in a chair, or lie down in a bed, whatever will be comfortable. You're going to close your eyes and go quietly inside and use focusing to go more deeply into answers to Blanchard's questions and your own action steps. So getting comfortable, in a chair or lying down, being in a place of peace and quiet where you can close your eyes for as much as 10 to 20 minutes. If you're not comfortable closing your eyes, you can just stare into space. So I want you to start by just noticing the feel of your body everywhere that it touches the chair or the bed. And if you have your feet on the ground, just notice the contact between your feet and the ground. Just noticing that the chair or the bed is really holding up your body so that you can relax. And now I invite you to just pay attention to your breathing. Just noticing the breath going in and out as a way of leaving your head and becoming more in touch with your body and your private and peaceful internal space. Just noticing the breath going in and out. In and out. And now notice where you have tension in your body. Maybe your face is all tight from smiling. You could squinch it up, move it around. The same with your neck and shoulders. Just noticing where you carry tension in your body. Massaging it a little if that helps. And now just imagine that tension as a stream of water flowing down your body and out through your fingers and toes. And breathe it out. And again, just imagine that tension from the top of your head going down your body and flowing out through your arms and legs. And breathe. Now just bring your attention with your eyes closed, if you can, toward the center of your body, a peaceful place around your heart and chest area. And now we're going to ask the first question. What mistake have I made that could benefit from a 1 minute apology? Is there something I have done which I carry as a weight, a fear, an unresolved tension? Have I dismissed another person, their wishes, their feelings, or ideas? Have I taken credit when it wasn't due? These are just possibilities. Ask yourself, is there a mistake that I have made? And just wait quietly, as long as a minute, for the intuitive feel, the felt sense of that whole thing to form in the center of your body. Not what you've already thought about it, but the body sense that comes. What is the mistake that I have made that could merit from a 1 minute apology? It could be at work, but it could be in your relationship, a child in your family, a friend. And now look for some words or an image or a gesture that begins to capture the feel of it all. Again, not what you already know, but making images freshly from that sitting with the feel of it all. And taking any words or images or gestures that come and checking them against the body feel and going back and forth between the body feel and words or images until your body says, yes, that's it. That's just right. That's the mistake I made that I could do an apology for. And now, if it fits for you, ask Blanchard's next question. Why did I do this? Some suggestions are impulsivity or thoughtlessness, or maybe it was calculated. Maybe it was from fear, anger, or frustration. But ask yourself, what was my motivation? And see what comes inside, not the already known, but what comes as the intuitive feel, your body knowing. What was my motivation for this whole mistake? And sit quietly with the center of your body, the whole feel of it. And begin to look for some words or an image that can capture that body feel, that where your body says, oh, that's just right. And go back and forth until you find those words for the body feel. What was my motivation? And looking for words or an image that are just right. And now ask Blanchard's question, how long have I let this go on? Is this the first or a repeated time? Is this behavior becoming a pattern in my life? And see what comes in the center of your body. Again, not the words you've already said over and over in your head a million times, but the fresh body sense, the intuitive feel. Is this the first and only time? Or how widespread is this behavior in my life? And again, how long have I let this go on? See what comes in the center of your body when you sit quietly. The body feel. And carefully looking for some words or an image or even a gesture that can capture that body feel, and taking any words that come and checking them until your body sense says, yes, that's it. Back and forth. With the question, how long have I let this go on? Is it a pattern in my life? And Blanchard's next question, what is the truth I am not dealing with? Is there some truth I'm not dealing with? And again, don't answer with what you've already thought. Just wait quietly and see what comes in the center of your body. What is the truth I don't want to see here? And carefully looking for some words or an image that can capture that body feel, going back and forth until your body says, yes, that's it, that captures it. What is the truth I'm not dealing with? Going back and forth until you find words or images and your body says, yes, that's it. And now ask yourself, am I better than this behavior? And see what comes. Not what you've already thought, but the body sense that comes in response to that question. Am I better than this behavior? Does this fit with who I think I am? And look for some words or an image or a gesture that exactly capture that image of who I am at my best. Going back and forth until you find words or an image that exactly capture your body sense. And now spend some time with Blanchard's action steps for how you surrender by apologizing as quickly as you can to everyone that you've injured, and how you have integrity by committing yourself to change that behavior by making whatever amends or restoration you can. So you're going to ask yourself, am I ready and able to do this? Am I ready and able to make that apology? What would be needed for me to take this action? Do I need some kind of support or help? Someone to go with me, someone to talk to about it first. And make a list of how you're going to carry out these action steps when you open your eyes. But first, let's just sit with, am I ready to make this apology? And what kind of support would I need to get ready to take the step of apologizing with surrender? And the second question after this, we'll take some time with this, will be, how am I going to make amends or restoration? But right now, am I ready to make this apology? And what kind of support might I need to be ready? And checking with your body sense. Am I ready? Just let your body sense come. Looking for words or images to exactly capture that. Am I ready? Going back and forth, checking and resonating until the words and images are just right. And also asking yourself, what kind of support might I need or could I find to help me be ready? Do I need to talk about this with someone, bring someone with me? Just ask yourself, if I'm not exactly ready, what kind of support or help would get me to that point of surrendering and making that apology? And looking for some words or an image that are just right to capture this readiness, this need for support, possibly. Any action steps that need to be taken so that I can make this apology? You might think for a moment about the consequences and how you're going to deal with them. And in fact, that can bring us to the next question, which is, how can I make amends or restitution? But I see those are two separate questions. So first, I'm going to have you ask yourself, what could be the consequences for me and other people of my making this apology? And am I ready to deal with those? And now, what kind of amends could I make? What kind of restitution I could make, could I make to overcome the damage that I've made by my mistake? And as a part of my apology. And again, don't answer with what you've already thought in your mind. Just see what comes in the center of your body. This will be a body wisdom much greater than anything you can think at one time. What are the amends or restitution I could make? Carefully look for some words or an image for that whole body knowing, and check any words or images against that body knowing until the words and images exactly capture your body wisdom. And now, come back into the room. Hopefully you can find a piece of paper and pencil and you can write down whatever you've come to through this exercise, particularly the steps you need to take to make sure you can make this apology and the amends and restitution that you're going to offer. Thank you for going with me on this journey. I hope it's been helpful for you. You can sign up for my free e-course on Gendlin's focusing and Carl Rogers' empathic listening and how they fit into every aspect of our work and family life at www.cefocusing.com. Thank you for your attention.